Welcome to the public hearings for the Legislative Assembly Economy and Infrastructure Committee's inquiry into Victorian universities in investment in skills.
What opportunities are there for improved collaboration between universities and TAFEs to address Victoria's skills needs?
I think that there's a real opportunity around the potential to establish centres of skills excellence, so to speak. So if we align centres of skills excellence to the Victorian Skills Plan, there's an opportunity for us to potentially adopt a hub and spoke model.
Industry at the core, industry on campus, and doing so productively for job creation and education is really the way forward.
My question to the group is, how can dual sector universities and the Victorian government work together to address skill shortages in rural and regional areas?
Government, industry and the universities all working together, really pushing that idea of cooperative learning where we have co-curriculum design, co-delivery, and making sure that we build in the centres of excellence and the training packages which the industry in the rural and regional areas needs.
Having a tri-sectoral or multi-sector campus, which is what Duncan is talking about too, I think, with a school, TAFE and uni all in one site is incredibly powerful. Coffs Harbour is a good example.
What is the role of micro-credential courses in developing the workforce skills that Victoria needs, and what is the role of universities in promoting the uptake of micro-credentials?
The term is problematic because out there in sort of punter land, not everyone gets what micro-credential is, means or does. I think what's actually talking about is just-in-time credentials, just-in-place and jobs where you live.
Where industry tell us that they want micro-credentials or credentials or non-accredited training in order to upskill their workforce, it's often the case that those particular programs will be developed, but then it's hard to get industry to release their people to actually participate. And so that, again, it's important to incentivize industry to do so.
How can universities and the Victorian government work together to encourage enrolments in priority skill areas?
I would advocate really strongly that they have a industry participation at that level, year 11 and 12, guiding us in the areas that should be offered and what we can support, and guiding the support, for example, for scholarships and or bursaries for students to make the transition.
So I think we need to be much more divergent in building in the value of multiple educational outcomes and qualification outcomes for Victorians, and really broadening out that sense that access to education is not and should not be dependent on ATAR alone.
What more can the Victorian government do to support universities to embed work integrated learning into university courses?
There is some work to be done, particularly around removing any of those real or perceived barriers that industry have with respect to engaging with international students in work integrated learning. And that is a key to the success of the international students in being able to engage with the workforce, because they bring huge skill capacity.
How we match both applied research, workforce development, new and emerging graduate requirements, all within an ecosystem of an employer or of an industry grouping, is really crucial for us to shift from transactional as part of this solution to a much more evolved approach.
And I'm wondering also, just lastly, wondering whether there's an opportunity of a grant towards maybe commencement costs if an employer recruits a graduate who went to them on work placement. And that might encourage further engagement with industry, with universities, and also provides that pipeline of talent.